This is how we will connect the Arduinos. We will connect two of them with pin 2 of one Arduino connected to pin 3 of the other Arduino, and pin 3 connected to pin 2 of the other Arduino, ensuring that the grounds are also connected. I will explain points 2 and 3 in the code later. But software serial is not actually a hardware UART pin. Instead, it uses these two GPIO pins as UART pins through software programming. So 2 is connected to 3, and 3 is connected to 2, with this 2 being the RX pin. Therefore, this RX pin is the TX pin on the other side. Pin 3 is the TX pin, and on the other side, it's the RX pin. And since connecting only the GPIO will not allow current to flow, we need to connect the ground like this. Let's go back to the code from last time. As I mentioned earlier, one side is always sending packets, while the other side is just always receiving. So there are roles for sending and receiving. So the sketch is like this right now. But while I can separate the sketches for sending and receiving in the sketch project, I wonder if that would be cumbersome. In my case, what I plan to do is first. After completing the surface mount device SMD process, it was mentioned that the software serial library is being utilized in this project. This library allows for serial communication on other digital pins, which is particularly useful for projects requiring multiple serial connections. Additionally, it appears that the software serial functionality is integrated and actively running within the sketch during live operation. This inclusion is a crucial component for enabling this capability, making it an essential part of the overall system design. Please simply add this, and then the RX and TX pins will just be in the correct order from here, correctly and properly. So cross-connect them, pin 2 of one Arduino to pin 3 of the other, and pin 3 to pin 2. I connected it this way. And then here as well, I will keep the baud rate the same for MySQL begin, 5600, and then I will erase this part, right after. I think I should leave this part for a moment. I'll set it aside and first focus on the role of the sender, like if, loli, lol, send, and if. In this case, we should leave the position of role R12 empty for the time being. After that, we will refer to this specific code and copy it exactly as it is written. This way, we can ensure that the code is sent out every 3 seconds without any issues. By following this method, we can maintain the integrity of the process and avoid any potential errors that might occur if we were to deviate from the original instructions. It is crucial to adhere to these steps to achieve the desired outcome. This is how it's done. And then I erased it. I have organized the code now, and I have set up macro constants for role, sender, and role receiver. Currently, the macro constant for role is currently set to send. But if you wish, it can be changed to role. Receiver. Next, in the software serial section, I declare the instance and set the RFC TX pin for 2 and 3. And then when I call begin, I set the baud rate to 9600, just like using the serial. Set the baud rate, and then, just like we did last time, set up the buffer. Configure the data format, create the packet, and then actually send it. Serial, write, buffer, This way, the one acting as the sender will send to the receiver side, and now it checks if my serial connection is established properly. To provide more context, the sender initiates the communication by transmitting data packets. The receiver, on the other hand, waits for these packets and verifies their integrity. Since this is essentially the packet length anyway, you can either incorporate it or not. If you don't actually incorporate it, it won't go in here because if there's no zero, it won't accommodate. So don't worry about it. I have set it up so that the output appears as hex values in the serial monitor for better readability. If it is functioning properly as a receiver, it will execute from here without any issues, but if it is acting as a sender, it will run from lines 22 to 27 in the code. If it is a receiver, it will run from lines 29 to 32 in the code. But the setup will be the same regardless. I will first upload this code to the sender device. The upload process is complete. And now I will change this to a receiver and upload it again. The upload process is complete once again. As you can clearly see, I have labeled this device as the sender and this one as the receiver. The USB cable is currently providing power only to the devices, and the receiver is connected to the PC. In this state, when I open the serial monitor and wait for a moment, I can see the packets being sent from the sender displayed in byte form every 3 seconds. If you don't know exactly, it is displayed with a timestamp. And this is how the current value is being output. In this session, we first connected two Arduinos with one sending packets and the other receiving them. The receiving Arduino accepted the packets and displayed them on the PC. In the next session, we will add code to the receiving side to pass and display which packets and what information they contain. I will see you next time.